We need to talk about the new Victron Orion XS 50 amp DC to DC charger and the wire sizes that it needs. Now, if you don't already know what this new charger is and what it does, well, I've got a separate video about that, and I'll link to that in the video description so we can just get right into why you clicked on this video, which is wire sizes. The screw terminals on the bottom of the Victron Orion XS can accept a maximum of 4-gauge wire, which will be large enough for 95% of use cases. So let's make sure that you are part of that 95%. For DC to DC chargers, we recommend keeping the voltage drop on the incoming wire limited to a max of 10% voltage drop. This isn't a code or a standard, but is a safe threshold based on our historical experience of the thousands of systems that we've helped with here on this channel. With 4-gauge wire with 105-degree insulation, 10% voltage drop results in a max combined wire length from vehicle starting battery to 50-amp Orion XS charger of 90 feet or 45 feet of positive and 45 feet of negative. Any longer than that, and we're going to have to recommend upsizing the wires, and to do that, you could just use our wire size calculator to help based on the wire length that you need. But 45 feet of positive and 45 feet of negative will cover most applications, except maybe the longest fifth wheel RVs, where the electrical system is near the middle to the back of the camper. And a long tape measure is going to be your friend here. Now, if you're wanting to upgrade a pre-existing Orion 12-12-30 with the new Orion XS 12-12-50, you can absolutely use your pre-existing 6-gauge wire as long as you keep voltage drop in mind. With the same wire specs as earlier, now with the smaller 6-gauge wire with 105-degree insulation, you can swap the 30-amp charger for the 50-amp charger, given that your total wire length, positive plus negative, from starting battery to charger doesn't exceed 60 feet, or 30 feet of positive and 30 feet of negative. This is going to keep you within our 10% voltage drop threshold. So any longer than that, and we'd have to recommend you upsizing the wires, but 30 feet of positive plus 30 feet of negative is our most common length of Orion wiring kit that we sell in our store, so most of you wanting to upgrade should be good to go. So what size of fuse does the Orion XS need? So regardless of if you're using 6-gauge or 4-gauge wire for your Orion installation, the fuse size can be the same as the 30-amp Orion, which is 60 amps. A 60-amp fuse is what's recommended in the installation manual and will allow the 50-amp charger to not trip the fuse under normal operation, but is low enough that it will keep the wire protected in the event of a short, since 4-gauge and 6-gauge wire with 105-degree insulation is rated for 120 and 160 amps, respectively, when installed outside of an engine space and not bundled in conduit. So thinking about that fuse size, even in a worst case scenario of 10% voltage drop that we talked about earlier, this would mean that there would be 10% more watts drawn from the starter battery or alternator to overcome the voltage drop of the wire, feeding power to this charger. This means that for the charger to be able to supply its full 700 watts with 10% loss through the wire, that would mean that we would potentially be pulling 700 watts times 10% loss for a total of 770 watts from the starter battery or alternator. But 770 watts divided by the 14.7 volts that an alternator will supply is only 53.5 amps, which does not put us in danger of nuisance trips. So there you go. That's the math behind why we have sized our wiring kits for the new Orion XS the way that we have, and the guidelines that you can use to make sure that they're going to work in your scenario. If you're looking to upgrade your van or RV alternator charging, we have both the Orion XS and its associated wiring kits available in our store, and I'm going to leave links to that in the video description and the pinned comment below the video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.